In 1967, a Russian physicist named Victor Vesalago proposed a way to bend light and electromagnetism backwards. 33 years later, at Duke University, that idea became an invisibility cloak of sorts that launched a new technology called metamaterials, which promises to revolutionize communications and many other fields.
Yeah, there are no materials which do this in nature, and that is, you have to have a material which, when light enters it, it bends the wrong way.
And somewhere along the way, John decided, hey, we can make an invisibility cloak out of this. Even partially as a joke, I think, but you know, the math held up, and you could write down the prescription for a cloak, and it was fairly simple.
And pretty soon the phone lines were hot, and David said, we're going to build this stuff.
Once it was demonstrated we could make something that really didn't exist in nature before, it kind of took off, but people really didn't know what to make of it at first.
If you ask different people, you'll probably get different definitions of the term metamaterial. But from my perspective, a metamaterial is a structure that is designed in order to control some form of wave propagation. That wave could be light, could be sound, could be radio waves, but the fundamental idea is that you design a structure and that structure mimics natural materials and can then be used to control wave propagation.
It's very interesting that we don't think about how much of our communications is really now carried by waves. Things like cell phones, cellular communication, all the sorts of things that you might have for Wi-Fi, radar, millimeter wave imaging, things that you see in airports now. All of these devices, which have a very, very long history dating back to Maxwell and tons of research, all have new life in them because of metamaterials. Waves are a big part of our lives, and metamaterials really gives us a way to control those waves in ways that we haven't had before.
I thought, this has got to be wrong. And if I publish this, I'm going to be, you know, condemned as something not worthy of being a scientist or something. And indeed I was, but it didn't turn out to be wrong.